Hello everyone. Today we are going to do task number two from assessment number one and assessment number two. So before we start, we have to see there is a different rules. So on your AAT assessment, on the right side, you will see these tables there for the core benefits for task number two. So I just copied from AAT website to here to save our time. And there are van benefits in kind and the car benefit in kinds. So now we are going to do this task number two and assessment number one. So let's start. Mr. P has the use of a company car during 2023-24. All necessary information in respect of the car is detailed below. This is the template that I have created after a lot of hard work. And with this template, it is very, very easy to find the car benefit in kinds. So let's start it. So the first thing is list price. If we see the list price is 20,760 for Mr. P. So we just enter here 20,760. And the second question is this car was available for full year or part year? So it was available just for 6 months. So we will write it here. It is available for just a 6 month. The next question is the engine is hybrid, petrol, or electric? And the answer is here, petrol. The next thing is use of car. Is it for both private and the employee use as well? Yes. Yeah. So if it is just the use, there is no private use, there is no benefit in kind. And the next question is CO2 level. CO2 level here is 103 gram per kilometer. Yeah. And the next is the employee contribution for car cost? So the answer is employee contribution to the cost of car is 3,200 here. So the answer is yes. So now we know that company car list price is 20,760 and the capital contribution is 3,200. So maximum we know is locked at £5,000. If someone contributes, the maximum is £5,000. So 20,760 minus 3,200. So list price after capital contribution is £17,560 and taxable benefit kind without time apportion for 12 month is 7,560 multiplied by 25%. But stop here. How did we find out this 25%? Yes, let's see. So the first basic charge rate, if we see the CO2 emission level is 103 gram per kilometer and it's a petrol car. If we now look the rules here, so if the car is more than 55 kilogram, 55 gram per kilometer emits, so it is 16%. Yeah, so basic charge is 16%, and anything above is 1% for every extra 5 gram per kilometer. So in our case, 16% is a basic charge, and the extra is in our case. Yeah, so what we need to do is 100 minus 55 divided by 5 is equal to 9%. Yeah, so 100 minus 55 divided by 5. So why we said here 100? The reason is we have to bring it down to the nearest whole number. Yeah, so that is why it's 9%. So the next thing is, so 16 plus 9 is 25. Yeah. So now we know that the time apportion without time apportion is 7,560 multiplied by 25% is 4,390. But the car was not available for a full year. It was just available for half year. So we need to time apportion this one. So 7,560 divided by 12 multiplied by 6. So it will be equal to 4,000. What we need to do, taxable benefit in kind without time apportion is 7560 multiply by 25%. So it's without time apportion, and with time apportion is divided by 12 multiplied by 6. Yeah, so it will be 2195. And the next thing is imply contribution towards the use of the car. So if we look here, the employee also contributed £50 per month towards the use of the car. So 50 multiplied by 12 is equal to 300. So this 300, we will minus 2195 minus 300 will equal to 1895. So this will be the answer of our first question. So scale charge percentage will be 25%. We have already calculated. And the next one is taxable benefit on the provision of the car is 1895. The second thing is in a question, the examiner wants us to know what is the taxable benefit on the provision of the fuel. So taxable benefit on the provision of the fuel is 27,800 multiplied by 25%. Yeah. So why we are multiplying this one with 27,800? The reason is our so the HMRC figure for the fuel is 27,800. So this the AVT will provide you in your exam on the right side of your test. You can see this figure 27,800, which I copied from AAT. So the answer is 6950, but remember you have to time apportion. So 6950 divided by 12 multiplied by 6 equal to 3475. So the assessable benefit in kind is 5370. So this is the answer. Now the next thing is what is the so the next question is the next part. Miss G had the sole use of a company van for the whole of 2023-24. The van is an electric petrol hybrid and emits 50 gram per kilometer CO2, and there is a 60% private use as well. So what we need to do is taxable benefit on the provision of the van and taxable benefit on the provision of fuel. So let's see here this table, the HMRC provided and AAT as well. So for van, it is basic charge is 3960 and private fuel charge is 757. So the answer will be taxable benefit on the provision of the van is 3960 and taxable benefit on the provision of the fuel is 757. So we need to ignore the private use. So we even if there is a private use, the full amount will be taxable 757, yeah, in case of van. Let's do the task number 2, assessment 2, and the part number task 2, assessment 2. Yeah, so the so this one is task number 2, assessment 2, the same car benefit example. Yeah, so if we look here. Okay, so instead of doing this one, first we will do the part 2 from assessment number 1. It will be better, and then we will move forward there. Okay, here if you look now, this part number C is Mr. F was given the use of a company house for all of 2023-24. The house was treated as a job-related accommodation. Okay. The first thing is, if there is something, anything that is a job related, yeah, so there is no benefit in kind for a job related thing. S Limited paid for all the ancillary services at a total cost of 4,700 for 23-24. Mr. F net earning for 23-24 is 38,500. So taxable benefit in kind will be, is restricted to the net earning of 10%. So 38,500 multiplied by 38,500 multiplied by 10% is 3850. Yeah, multiplied by 10%, so will be 3850. The next one is Miss W received £10 per night in incidental expenses for 5 consecutive nights when working away from home in the UK. Okay, now there are the rules. Now we have to look here. This one I copied from AAT. So incidental overnight expenses within UK allowed is £5 per night. But here, Miss W was paid £10 per night. So it was paid double. So anything that was paid above the set level by HMRC, so the full amount will be benefit in kind. So 10 multiplied by 5 consecutive nights, the answer will be 50. The next one is Mr. R had the use of 2 mobiles for 23-24. Both were mainly used for business purpose and the cost is £50 per month each. So we know that only one mobile is allowed, so the other one will be benefit in kind. So answer will be 600. Mr. C received 2 interest-free loans from S Limited, 7,400 in January 23 and 9,200 in November 23. Mr. C has not repaid any of the loans. So if we use the average method, there are 2 methods, strict method and average method. So by average method, if we find, so balance at the beginning of the year in April was 7,400 and the balance at the end of the year was 9,200 plus 7,000 plus 9,200. So it is 16,600. So it was the at the end of the period, but what was the balance at the beginning of the year? 7,400. So total is 24,000. So we need to divide it by 2 to find the average balance. Divide by 2 and it is 12,000. So 12,000 we need to multiply by official rate of interest. That should be 2.25. It 2.25%. So the benefit in kind will be 270. Yeah. So these should be your answers. I'm just going to highlight here. So first 2, 3, and this one is the fourth one. Okay. No, there are true and false question. If fully electric car, which has no CO2 emissions, would be exempt from the taxation. True or false? It's false. A fully electric vehicle, the first year allowance is available for the electric car. So it is false, yeah. An asset bought by an employee for the private use, an employee would not be taxable benefit in kind if the asset costs less than £10,000. It's false. Free use of sporting facilities provided by an employer would not be taxable benefit in kind if the facilities are available to all employees. Yes, if it is available to all employees, then it is not a would not be taxable, so it will be true. If this is a keyword here, provided to all employees, so if it is just provided to one employee, then it was a different scenario. Yeah. Okay, this one is the task number 2, end of assessment number 1. Now we are moving to task number, same task for assessment number 2. Yeah. So in the task number 2, in assessment number 2, the question related to cars benefit. So there are two, one is Dr. D and the other one is Miss B. So we will do for both one. So Dr. D, the car was available for, so the list price is 36,100. Car registration date is 14th January 2021. So we can see here. So, so we are doing no for Miss B. Sorry for that. So it's Miss B. So the car is available for 8 months and the car is a diesel car. And there is a both private and employee use. And CO2 emission is 112 gram per kilometer. And the car cost contribution, no. And private fuel provided by an employer, yes. Yeah. So all these figures I just put into my format that I made it. So company car 36,100. There is Miss B did no contribution towards the cost of the car. Maximum she can contribute £5,000. So list price after capital contribution is 36,100, and taxable benefit coin without time apportion is 9,747. Remember, the car was available for only 8 months, so we need to time apportion. But first thing is, what we have to do is 97. Sorry, before 9,747 divided by 12 multiplied by 8, we will get 6,498, and implied contribution towards the use of the car is £120 per month. So £120 multiplied by 12 multiplied by 8, it will be equal to 960 because the car was available for 8 months. So total taxable benefit for the provision of the car will be 6,498 minus 960. Yeah. But here the question is, how we will find out this basic charge and this one. The first thing is we need to find out. So the reason is because this car is a diesel car, and its basic charge is 16%. And the remaining we will find out by 110 minus 55 divided by 5, it will be 11%. So why we did it like that? So because the reason is we need to scale it down. Yeah. So 112, we need to scale it down to 110. So 16 plus 11% is 27. And there is no additional charge due to pre-6 April because the car was registered after 2020 April, and because the diesel engine is compliant to RDE2, there is no additional charge. The next thing is fuel benefit in kind. So the annual fuel benefit kind is 27,800 multiplied by 27% is equal to 7,506, and the taxable benefit on the provision of fuel is 7,506 divided by 12 multiplied by 8, and it is equal to 5,004, and this will be the our answer. So taxable benefit on the provision of car is this one, and taxable benefit on the provision of fuel is this one, and the total scale charge will be 27%. So these three will be your answers for this task, these yellow colors one. Okay, now there is another part of the same task. Other part is about Miss Dr. D, yeah, the car. So the list price is, if you see here, is 26,200. Car registration registered on 30 September 2022, and the car was available for full year, 12 months, and it's a hybrid car. And CO2 level is 40 gram per kilometer, and implied contributed towards the cost of car is no. And is there anything else? Yeah. Implied contribution to cost of the car. Implied contribution to the cost of the car is, sorry, 6,500. Yeah. So the answer of this one is yes. Yeah. So 6,500. But the maximum capped is at £5,000. So more than £5,000 is not allowed. So that is why we capped it at £5,000. So the total list price after capital contribution is 26,200 minus 5,000 is 21,200. Taxable benefit in kind without time apportion. So first thing is we have to find out the basic this charge rate. So how we will find out? Because the CO2 emission is 40 gram per kilometer, and this electric range is 120 miles. So if we go to our this table, so if we look here, the CO2 is less than 50, is 40 in our case, and the electric range is 120. So this is the scaled 5% that we have to use. So what we will do is, now we will don't need to do any time apportion. We will get the answer is 1060. So this will be the answer. The next thing is, now what we have to do is, the other part of the same assessment is We will don't know the part two assessment tool. Okay, so here, if you see, Mrs. L moved into a house provided by Z Limited on 1st January 2020, when its market value was 295,000. The house cost Z Limited 210,000 pound in April 2012. The house has the annual value of 7,200. Mrs. L pays Z Limited 500 pound per month toward the use of the house. So the first thing is, if the house is the company purchased this house, so there are two benefits. One is normal benefit in kind, and the other one is an additional benefit in kind. So the first normal is annual value. So annual value is 7,200 pound, and because the house was purchased more than 7 years ago, we should not have to use this cost. We used to need to use the market value. So market value is 295,000 pound. 295,000 pound. So now what we have to do is, the formula is now 295,000 minus 75,000, that is allowance, and multiply by official rate of interest 2.25% is equal to 4,950. So this will be the additional benefit. So we have to add these two now. Add 7,200 plus 4,950 equal to 12,150, and Mrs. L also contributed. So contribution is how much is 500 multiplied by 12. So we need to minus this one for, because she contributed that one. So 12,150 minus 6,000 equal to 6,150 should be the answer. The next one is Mr. V moved 200 miles due to a promotion and received 9,500 help with removal expenses. The thing here now is 1 minute. So the 200 miles due to promotion and received 9,500 to help with the air removal expenses. So removal expenses are allowed up to, I think, should be 8,000 pound. So the difference between 9,500 and minus 8,000, so the taxable benefit in kind should be 1,500. Miss Kyo received an interest-free loan of 16,000 on 1st November. This is the only loan she has received, and she has not repaid any of this loan. So we know that the loan, interest-free loan, is up to 10,000 pound is a tax-free. So anything above 10,000 pound is, if the loan exceeds the 10,000 pound, it's not tax-free. Yeah. So the thing here now is, we have to do this one. Just a minute. So it means, so the full, this 16,000 pound will be taxed. Yeah. So will be taxed. So 16,000 pound multiplied by 2.25% should be 360. Yeah. And the next one is, Mr. Yu received a watch for his 30-year long service award. This was Mr. Yu's only long service award. And the watch cost 1,800 pound. So long service award, we will have to see here. Long service award. What is the long service award? Expensive motorcycle incident, or living expense, or mobile phone. So it is 50 pound per year. Yeah. So long service award is 50 pound per year. So 50 pound multiplied by 30. So 50 multiplied by 30, it should have to be 1,500, but he was given 1,800 pounds, so 300 pound will be the answer. 300 pound will be the correct answer. Yeah. Okay, the next thing is this true and false. Mr. F is the director of F Limited. She received a bonus of 2,500 on 30th of April 2023. The bonus was for the accounting period ending 31st March 2023. Mr. F will be taxed on the bonus during 2023 and 24. So, because Mr. F is a director, so for directors, there is a different thing. So, the bonus received was on 30th of April 2023, but this bonus was actually for 22-23, not 23-24. It's a false statement. HPLC pays all employees £5 per week for working from home, as all employees know work from home for part of the week. So is it a this employee will not be taxed on this allowance? So we will look working from home. No, working from home, working from home. Yeah, it's a £6 per week. Yeah. And here, pays all employees £5 per week. The employees will not be taxed on this allowance. So it is a true because it's less than £6. Mr. Y uses his own car for business purposes. His employees pays him 40p per mile. Mr. Y claimed 15,000 business miles. So we know that the first 10,000 miles. Yeah, so first 10,000 miles we need to be multiplied by 45p is equal to 4,500, and the remaining 5,000 will be at 25 pence, so it is 1250. So the total should have to be 5,750. But the thing is, what Mr. Y was paid is 15,000 multiplied by 40 pence, 6,000. So should have to be paid. Should have to be and actually paid. Actually paid is 6,000. So 6,000 minus 5,750. Is 250. So Mr. Y has an allowable expense of 250. It's wrong because he was overpaid. Should have to be paid 5,750, but paid 6,000. So 250 was extra. So this is a false statement. So this is the end of our today's lecture. So if you have any question, please send me an email. Or you can send me write in the comments. Please like and subscribe this channel. Thank you.